Today, you will finally learn what all those buttons on your calculator do. Unfortunately, I don't have the time to cover them all, so I'm going to use a basic calculator for my example, a TI-30 scientific calculator that appears in most schools. Let's get into it. Starting off, the number buttons input numbers, obviously, and the operation buttons perform operations. The equal sign button is more of a solve button, and so, to the best of my knowledge, that is why it is also labeled Enter. The decimal point button places a decimal point, and the button with the minus sign in parentheses allows you to place a negative sign, which does not also work as a subtraction sign. Starting with the smaller black buttons, the parentheses help with order of operations. The x to the negative 1 button and the x squared button place their own respective exponents, and the caret button can place any exponent. Next up are the more complicated operations, starting with these three, which stand for sine, cosine, and tangent. If you imagine a right triangle, and one of the acute angles is x degrees, then sine of x is this side over this side, cosine of x is this side over this side, and tangent of x is this side over this side. If you don't understand this yet, you will learn it eventually. Then we have these two, log and ln. Log is short for a logarithm, which is the opposite of an exponent, like how division is to multiplication. If 4 squared is 16, then log base 2 of 16 is 4. If you don't see a base, assume the base is 10. ln is the natural logarithm, which means ln of x is actually log base e of x, and e is a number equivalent to this. The PRB button stands for probability. This button opens a submenu of two different operations. Put one number to the left and one number to the right, and the answer will be how many different ways you could fit this number of things into this many slots. The P means order matters, and the C means order doesn't matter. That's all the operation buttons, so I can go through the rest of these pretty fast. This button allows you to choose angle measurements, and so does this button. DEG means degrees, RAD means radians, and GRD means gradients. I'll put the definitions up on screen now. The clear button clears everything to the right of your cursor. If nothing is there, it clears everything you typed. The delete button just works like a backspace key. This button lets you type fractions. These two have a strange variable system that I don't understand. These two have a variable system I do understand. Press this button to store your input into a variable, and this button to type your variables. The second button is like a control key on a computer. You press it, and then all the other buttons do what the blue text above the button says. I am not going to cover what all this means, because I don't want to. I'll link the official manual in the description. I forgot to add this in the initial recording, but the pi button is pretty self-explanatory anyway, so I don't think it matters. And finally, the on button turns the calculator on.